Hey guys, I've recently acquired this little SAS server hard drive here. It's a 146 gig, I think it's a 10,000 RPM HP drive, probably from an HP ProLiant server of some kind. It's marked as bad here, so I imagine it failed in some manner. I don't know if it's totally dead or if it's just failing a smart test. But I'm probably not going to be able to actually use it because I don't have anything with a SAS or SAS interface on it here. You can see that's not exactly the normal SATA. It's got these smaller pins here, and then it doesn't have the gap between there. It looks very, very similar to SATA. This is actually the first SAS or SAS drive that I've ever even had or been able to look at, so it's kind of interesting to me. But what I thought was really interesting was this little caddy that it's in. It's a very, very interesting, very nice design. You press this little tab here, and it swings out, a little lever swings out. This is actually heavy-duty metal lever here, and that would allow you to pull this out of the server chassis. And when you would go to put this back in, there's this little clip here, and it would slide in there, and when you push down, it would lever this thing back on in and force the drive into the socket properly. And if I go ahead and remove the drive from this little cradle, I'll show you something that's really interesting. Because I was looking at this and I saw these indicator lights on the front here. I wonder how the drive is connected to those, you know, because I'd think that it would have to have some way to power those LEDs. And got looking around and saw, oh, looks like these are little light pipes in the back here. So the LEDs aren't actually in the little caddy here. They're actually in the server like slot where this goes in, but way in the back by the connectors. So that's kind of a novel way of doing that, really. So I'm going to go ahead and pull the drive out of here. I don't know if we'll really learn a whole lot from this, but drive's bad anyway. Might as well crack it open. Won't be taking apart the hard drive itself quite yet. I may do that in a later video. But plan on keeping this caddy around in case I would ever happen to get a ProLiant server or something that this would fit into. And I could test the drive and possibly reuse this caddy, because I've seen these things go for quite a ridiculous amount of money on eBay, so they must still demand quite a price tag. Right, here we've got the drive itself, and you'll notice this thing is incredibly chunky. If I can get the little protective thing, which is lovely and blue inside, and stick that over there. It's a really interesting looking drive. It's 3.5 inch, or not 3.5, 2.5 inch form factor. So it's like normal laptop drive, but about twice or three times as thick. It's really chunky and it weighs a lot of weight to this little bugger. And it's only 146 gigs, but I'm wondering how many platters are in here. And this is a 10,000 RPM drive, so it's a powerful little drive. I don't know where this drive came from. The guy that gave it to me, his son found it in the trash, so don't know. Could be from anywhere, but it's got a little BGA-mounted LSI chip here on the bottom, probably the main controller for it. Samsung chip here, which I would imagine would be some sort of RAM or cache. Smooth, don't know, probably some kind of disk controller. Yeah, the rest is just some passives and whatever this quad flat pack is here. Some inductors and things. It's a lot chunkier than a normal laptop drive. Kind of curious, actually, to pull this little thing apart. It's got the HP service tag stuff and serial number on there. 3U, I don't know if that means it came out of a 3U server or what this is actually from. 146 gig, 10K SAS single port. HP model DG146ABAB4. Made in Singapore. Interesting. yeah, when you pull this drive out here, you can see here, focus. All right, we see these little light pipes here. And these can actually, I believe they can come out of here. Yep. Try not to break them. It might break them doing that. Nope, got them. Really nice little light pipes that travel all the way from the rear of the unit up to the front I.O. panel. I would imagine one of these would probably be for like hard drive activity, and the other one may be a fault light or possibly hard drive power. Not sure how that would be set up, but they almost have kind of a fiber optic effect to them, but I don't know if they're actually glowing on the ends or not. I don't think so. Probably have to apply a lot more light to it. Actually, I've got an Arduino over here that just so happens to be powered. I can move it into place and see. Sorry, I've got this out of frame here. No, actually, those LEDs on there are not bright enough to light up the ends, so this thing must, inside, must have a remarkably bright LED to actually get that to work. So, these are not that effective at transferring light through them. Kind of surprised, actually. Hmm. Interesting little design, though. It's actually got this little spacer in here that's made out of a different material, and looks like it's clipped in there, all modular. Really neat. There's a little ventilation area in here so you get proper airflow to the drive. Because I imagine a 10,000 RPM laptop-sized drive would get pretty hot. I mean, that's probably comparable to like one of the Western Digital Velociraptors. Actually, I'm not sure who makes this hard drive. Let's see if we can find a manufacturer on here. ST 914. That's probably a Seagate. I'm thinking this is a Seagate drive. There's no branding on this at all. But I am gonna guess that is a Seagate drive. It doesn't look like any other hard drive I've seen, so I have no idea, but I'm gonna take a wild guess and say this is probably a Seagate drive. Alright guys, well, if you know any way I could hook one of these things up to a standard SATA computer, or possibly get a cheap SAS SAS controller for a modern computer, like a PCI Express one or something, let me know in the comments. If you thought this was interesting, go ahead and let me know and like the video and get subscribed and for any content like this, any more like this. And you guys have a good one now.